is the proactive oxygen concentrator that we have received from US on donation. And as all of you know that the common voltage output in US is 110 to 120 volts. So the same thing is with this concentrator. The input that's required for this concentrator is 120 volts. And in India, the voltage output is 220 volts. So before we use this concentrator, we need to have a voltage converter, which will convert the input of 220 volts that we get in India to output of 110 volts so that our concentrator can work. So if you are planning, whenever you are planning to use this concentrator, ensure that you have got a voltage converter. So attach your concentrator to the voltage converter, switch on the converter, and then you switch on your machine and start your flows. Now when you start the flows, in initial stages the FiO2 will not be 100%. It will take some time for FiO2 to go to 100%. So you will see the light fluctuating between green, orange and red, and as your FiO2 that's coming is steady 100%, then you will see that your green light is steadily lighting. So that ensures that now the concentrator is delivering 100% FiO2. Now this concentrator also comes with a humidifier bottle and a tubing, which, so this is your oxygen output port. So this will get attached over here and the humidifier bottle will be fixed into this slot. From this bottle, you have got another output which will go to the patient. So the patient tubing, either through nasal prongs or the mask, will be fixed on this output. Now this bottle, you are supposed to fill water. However, you understand that the oxygen that's coming out from here is at the room temperature, and the water that you are going to fill in is also going to be at the room temperature. So no matter how much oxygen bubbles through this, the pickup of the moisture or the water vapor is going to be negligible. On top of that, when that oxygen is going to traverse through this long tubing, which is again exposed to the room cold, room temperature, that negligible amount of water vapor that we picked up will again get precipitated in this tubing. So ultimately, the result of bubbling the oxygen through this water is zero. In addition, this water can also act as source of infection, either the contaminated water or the bottle which is not clean. With the rising incidence of mucormycosis, many clinicians feel that this water also may be a culprit to cause the contamination. So in my opinion, we should not be using the oxygen humidifier. You can just remove, get with this bottle, and you can attach directly the tubing to the patient's device to the oxygen output port. Now this oxygen output port, what is just to ensure that it is giving the FiO2 what it is meant to, that's 100%. We also checked with the gas monitor. So you can see that now this gas monitor is exposed to the room air. The FiO2 or the NO2 that you can see over here is 20%. Now I'm just going to attach it to the output of the concentrator and let's see what happens to the oxygen concentration that's coming out. So you can see that it's steadily increasing. So we know that this oxygen concentrator output is almost 99% FiO2. Now this was at 1 liter flow. Now I am going to increase this flow to maximum of 5 liters. So remember, this concentrator gives maximum 5 liters flow per minute of oxygen. And you can see now there the oxygen concentration is still 100%. So we know that this concentrator is giving the output of 100% FiO2 to the maximum flows of 5 liters.